For me, Black History Month is great, but I live Black history every day. And so for me, it is sharing our stories and for people to see more of who we are.
Candace Bellamy's story started in Knoxville, Tennessee, a long way from Buda.
So I'm the oldest of three, and my mom raised me. My mom and dad separated when I was young. But I knew from a young age that I wanted to help people, and I knew that I wanted to be a doctor. And I never doubted that I could. And my mom was such an important influence because she told me from a young age that I could be anything I wanted to be, and I took her at her word.
Today, Candace is a family practice doctor.
I actually am a family practice doctor for the military, and I've been a practicing physician for the last 20 years and really enjoy that and have had a varied career. I've not only worked for the military, I've worked in the prison system in a men's maximum security prison, private practice and urgent care. So it's been a really incredible journey.
That journey eventually led her to Texas, but it wasn't medicine that brought her here.
With a smile on my face, for the whole human race.
In her free time, Candace trades in her stethoscope for a microphone.
So a few years ago, I needed a hobby, and at the time I lived in Tennessee, that's where I'm from, and that's where I initially started practicing. And I started taking voice lessons, and the person I took voice lessons from said, you know, you really should sing. And so I started a band in Tennessee and really wanted to do more. And my friend said, if you really want to, you know, do music, you should move to Austin. It's the live music capital. So that prompted my move to Texas.
Where you go, Johnny?
I've had several bands that I've been in and that I, you know, have started, and it's been a lot of fun. I do R&B, soul, and jazz music, and I've recorded albums. Worked with some incredible people in the music community.
Eventually, she ended up moving to Buda to escape the hustle and bustle of Austin.
So I think when I looked at Buda, one of the things that it reminds me of is growing up in Tennessee. You know, just the sort of the backdrop with the trees and then the, you know, main street that, you know, coming through, that reminds me of growing up in Tennessee, growing up in a small town. I think it's important in any community that you're in that you are, you know, present and involved, and it just grows the community and makes the community better. You know, as Buda continues to grow and expand and become more diverse, I think it's that much more important to be seen and involved.
For Candace, sharing the stories of those in the African American community has become a big part of her life. On top of being a doctor and an accomplished singer, she also hosts her own TV show in Austin.
Come and take your coffee break with me.
I do a TV show on a local channel in Austin called Coffee Break with Candace. And so I interview people from all over the world, and they share their stories. And I've just had an incredible roster of people that have been on.
Currently, she's working on a documentary about Dr. Joycelyn Elders, the first African-American U.S. Surgeon General of the United States, and only the second woman to lead the U.S. Public Health Service.
In a story like Dr. Elders, we're not telling those stories. We're not telling the story of a woman who, you know, was the daughter of a sharecropper who didn't have running water and electricity, who rose to the highest, you know, medical position in the nation. And so I think it's really important, you know, that those stories are visible.
Candace would also like to help prepare students going into medical school, particularly students of color.
One of the things that I would love and has been a dream of for several years is to create programs, pre-med programs, and particularly to ready students, particularly students of color, for medical school. Because it's you can have great grades and everything in college, but medical school is another, you know, it's a whole different ball game. And if I can prepare students for success at the college level, for them to be successful in medical school, that's something I want to do.
On the topic of racial inequality and racial divide, Candace believes the youth of our country are taking a stand in a way that she didn't when she was young.
at least what I've witnessed is that young people are, they're all in. They're already having these conversations. When I talk to my niece on the phone, who just turned 17, I mean, she's aware of these issues and she talks about them in a way that I didn't talk about them growing up. It feels like there's a better conversation happening, especially with the younger generation. And actually, they're inspiring to me because I grew up in a different generation where we worked hard. That's how we proved ourselves, and we didn't have those uncomfortable conversations. I never had those growing up, although I clearly saw it, especially growing up in the South, growing up in Tennessee, oh my goodness.
Moving forward, she would like to see more representation of different cultures in the Buda community, and is hopeful that uncomfortable conversations in communities across the country will bring continued change.
What can people do? Have conversations. I think that's the most important thing, ask questions. It's not uncomfortable for me to ask questions or have someone ask me questions. What is uncomfortable is for people to make assumptions.